So Ryan, these bars were closed because of the risks of the virus spreading, and you've got new research that backs that up.
Yeah, Carolina, and it's coming straight from the Centers for Disease Control. It might seem a bit obvious, but they have new research that suggests going out to eat and drink can actually be pretty risky. Here's a deeper dive into their investigation. So 314 people took part in the CDC study, which found that adults who tested positive for COVID-19 were twice as likely to have gone to a restaurant in the 2 weeks before they got sick. That's compared to people who tested negative. Positive patients were also more likely to report going to a bar or coffee shop. The CDC also said the airflow in restaurants might contribute to the spread. Restaurants, by the way, in South Florida are mandated to keep their doors and windows open. Now, with that in mind, I talked to Dr. Jay Wolfson tonight of USF Health. He said as long as the governor is able to monitor what's happening carefully and watch the data, he's comfortable with the state reopening bars at half capacity. Ultimately, Dr. Wolfson said the responsibility is on you.
It's not going to be easy to do. Folks have been bending the rules. The goal here is to limit the number of people who are inside so you can see what's going on. Bottom line, common sense. Because if you're in this room and with a bunch of people you don't know and they're coughing, sneezing, or yelling and having a good time, we want them to do that, but we're not out of the woods yet.
Dr. Wolfson also noted it is important that we watch the numbers over the next 2 weeks following the Labor Day weekend to see if we do have another spike in case numbers, Carolyn.